It's interesting. Economics went through this change, and it occurred roughly in the 90s, you know, extending a little bit in the 2000s, where it went kind of a quantitative revolution, where before then, economics was much about theory. You know, like, here is our theory of how this market works and so on. But around the 90s, at least in microeconomics, more data became available and computing processing power got good enough that we could analyze it. If you think of like some of the really big issues that we're talking about and struggling with in the US over the past, you know, 5 to 10 years, I mean, really longer than that, but like they've really, you know, been heavily discussed, a lot of it boils down to this educational equity issue. Until we get that piece under control, it's hard, you know, to deal with other pieces as well. For Missouri, for example, we grabbed all third graders from like a four-year period, and we saw how did they score on their statewide tests in third grade, and what percentile in the distribution were they? And then we tracked them forward all the way through high school, through when they graduated.